Hello and welcome back to Numereal. It's your boy Damon the Real Nailer. We truly thank you for tuning in. We appreciate you. We have a wonderful episode in store for you today. We want to let you know that we're still praying for everyone, praying that you would have strength during this time, praying for those who may have lost anyone, for comfort for you, and just praying that all of us will make it through the situation and maintain our health, maintain our sanity. We have a great episode, as we stated, in store for you today, and what we're going to look at is this concept, in fear or in faith. As we look at right now, we have to ask ourselves, we have to analyze our lives and ask, am I walking in fear or am I walking in faith? We want to look at the scripture in 2 Timothy 1 and 7. It says, for God has not given us a spirit of fear, but of power and of love and of a sound mind. Let me repeat that. For God has not given us a spirit of fear, but of power and of love and of a sound mind. Right off the bat, two revelations we want you to get about the concept of fear. First of all, it's not of God. In essence, it didn't emanate from God. He did not give that to you. He's not the source of it. First of all, that's the first thing we need to know. With that in mind, automatically, by default, we know it's not good since it did not come from God. Well, where did it come from or what is it? It's a spirit. What type of spirit? Either your human spirit or a demonic spirit. And if it's a demonic spirit, normally that source, that agent will try to play tricks with your mind. He'll make you feel anxious, stressed, worried, all of those things to promote and generate fear and to try to cause you to actually go insane. And that's what we have to recognize first. This did not come from God. It's either within me as a weakness, or it's a demonic spirit that's trying to afflict me and cause me to feel this way. Now, looking at fear and faith, what we're going to do is compare the two. They don't come alone. They come basically as a package deal with other components and elements that come along with them. So we're going to do a comparison and a contrast in here, rather, of fear and faith. So first of all, with faith came power. It said God has not given us a spirit of fear, but of power, first of all. So with the Holy Ghost comes power. It comes with boldness. It comes with courage. And we have the mighty power through it. We have divine supernatural strength. And actually, one of the gifts of the Spirit is faith. And actually, one of the fruit of the Spirit is faith. Then it talks about the breastplate of faith and love and the shield of faith. So we're all surrounded with faith spiritually. We got to get this point. The opposite of faith, so if it comes with power, then the fear will produce weakness. And if a person, when you have a spirit of fear, and I thank God for deliverance because I suffered with fear when I was a young child, it makes you feel vulnerable, it makes you feel weak, it makes you feel powerless, as though you can't do anything, you're under the subjection of the enemy, you're under subjection of your situation. That's what fear will literally do. It will cripple you, okay? So then we move on to the next one. It says that it also comes with love. God has not given us spirit of fear, but of power. Then it says love. So perfect love casts out fear. And 1 John 4 and 18, it says there is no fear in love. I love how it comes all together. There is no fear in love, but perfect love or complete love casts out fear, because fear involves torment. But he who fears has not been made perfect or complete in love. In essence, this is saying if you struggle with fear, then you need more love. You need more of the love of God, which is shed abroad in our hearts by the Holy Ghost. And we have to suppress any fear within us and allow the Holy Spirit, the power of God, to shine through us so that his love may be made perfect through us. And then it also says that faith, which works by love. In essence, the faith that we have should be grounded in love. It should emanate from a place of love. Love should be your source of faith and believing God. And then on the opposite side, so if the God spirit comes with love, then fear comes with hate. In essence, you dislike or you abhor. You would be surprised how many people who hate others is really out of a source of fear. You know, hate is not the strong man or the chief problem. The chief problem in most instances is actually their fear. I mean, because they fear them, they dislike and abhor them. And so some people's hate is actually caused by that fear. And then here's the principle. You typically hate what you are afraid of. I know when I was a child, thank God I had to overcome this aversion, but I think most people, even adults, don't like shots or are afraid of shots. And so because you are afraid of shots, you hate shots, you know. Some people are afraid of going to the doctor's office or the dentist's office. Why? Because sometimes we associate those places with pain. And because we are afraid of it, we also hate it. And so you would be surprised of people who have hate in their hearts and dislike, and know that it's actually not from a source of hate, but it's actually from a source of fear. And if you, in those people's lives, if you remove the fear, then a person will actually begin to love. The person will actually begin to feel comfortable and can manage situations where they have to confront the thing that they're afraid of, if they're able to overcome that fear. Moving right along to the last one. So it says, God had not given us a spirit of fear, but of power, love, and that sound mind, which is the mind of Christ, which comes with the Holy Spirit. So it gives us discipline, strong mental control, mighty power through God. And through God's power, we're able to pull down strongholds, cast down imaginations, and bring thoughts into captivity and subjection. Now, I want to stay on this concept of pulling down strongholds. First of all, what are strongholds? Strongholds are fortresses or defensive systems that the enemy literally sets up in our minds. When an enemy gets access to a certain part of our mind, he literally is able to set up a defense mechanism, set up a fortress, a system to actually keep you from accessing that part of your mind. This is so powerful. God revealed to me. And so what happens, you can't even get access to that part of your mind when the enemy has set up a fort. But here, through the power of God, through the power of the Holy Spirit, through the weapons of our warfare, we're able to pull down these defensive fortresses that the enemy has established in places in our minds. And once we're able to pull them down, then we're able to cast down imaginations and bring our thoughts into captivity unto the obedience of Christ. If we don't have that power, then the enemy would still hold or have strongholds in our minds. You know, people suffer with all kind of mental illnesses, and believe it or not, it's because a demonic force has actually gained access to that person's mind, and that person needs the deliverance power of God in order to get access back to that place so that they can have a sound mind again. And now when we look at it, what the opposite of that sound mind would be that comes with fear would be paranoid and delusional. So people who have fear, eventually they begin to become paranoid and delusional. And what's the result? What are the results of that? They have crazy thoughts, bizarre ideas. They're tormented in their mind, and they're even restless. And so what happens throughout life, and especially when we're being a parent educator, one thing we've learned is that as children or just people in general, we're not supposed to undergo traumatic or lots of stress for more than 20 minutes. And once it gets past 20 minutes, it becomes what's called toxic stress. And once we're facing toxic stress, our body begins to secrete the hormone cortisol. And what that does, it begins to affect our brain. It begins to literally kill brain cells, and that affects our memory, our attention, our concentration, and also our cognitive, you know, thoughts, and, you know, our thinking, our reasoning. And you'll be surprised of the people who have mental disorders and cognitive issues, and it's actually based from fear, or the source is fear, because they face so much trauma as a child or even as adult. They have now, you know, that the cortisol has been secreted, and it's been secreted in excess, that their minds are just messed up. And you'd be, like I say, it would be shocking to know that, wow, the source of this was not, you know, that was passed down or imbalance in chemicals in their brain, but it's actually due to fear. So we want you to know that God has not given us this. This is from the devil. And I know we're going through some challenging, some trying times. It's normal to fear, but as the people of God, as Christians, born again, full of the Holy Ghost, He does not want us to be afraid. He constantly said, fear not throughout the word. Fear not. Fear not. Be courageous. Be bold. When you get the Holy Ghost, you will have power. And that's what he wants us to walk in. If we're going to be a witness, especially during these unstable, challenging, unpredictable times, then we got to get a hold of faith. We have to believe God and his word, and we have to walk in this thing. We have to pull on those strongholds of fear, those strongholds of anxiety, worry, and everything that we're facing, all of these negative emotions. We have to bring them into captivity, subject them to God, so that we can walk in the mind of Christ, or manifest the mind of Christ, and have those thoughts that are true, honest, just, lovely, pure, a good report with virtue and praise. So we thank you truly for tuning in. We hope that you're inspired now to walk in faith, recognizing and understanding that it is not from God. It's the devil, or it's just me, and I got to get over this thing. I got to maintain my sanity. I got to maintain my love. I got to retain my power, because that's what God has promised me and given me. We hope that you tune in next time. Please share this message with somebody. Get the word out that people should tune into Numeril so they can get some insight and some understanding and get some inspiration and education so they can live victorious daily lives. We appreciate you. We love you. And we'll see you soon in Jesus' name.